Hey all, welcome back to another episode. This is Shubhanga here from Quantsapp. So in the previous videos, we had understood about what is implied volatility, what is India VIX, and what is PCR, what is options open interest and all that. So if you want to watch all those videos, so the link would be in the description box below. Talking about this video, we are going to discuss about IVR, what is IVP, so implied volatility or rank percentile. Then first we will try to understand what is the impact of IVs on our option premiums, and then we will quickly understand how exactly the IV behaves. Then using IVRs and IVP, how it is going to benefit us in our trading system. So that is something we will try to understand in this video. So first let's try to understand the impact of implied volatility on our option using the option chain what if analysis. So I have selected my symbol as HDFC Bank. Futures price is 1448.45. We can get to see the expiry as well. Now, if we focus on all of the strikes, especially let's try to focus on 1440 call and put. So call is trading at 23 and put is almost trading at 14 rupees. Now, using the IV slider, let's try to understand the impact of IV on our premiums. Now, whatever the current IV is, let's say if the IVs cool down by 25% from here. So I have given an input that whatever the current IV is, from that IVs will take a cooler down approach of HDFC Bank by 25%. So in the same scenario, despite my futures price being the same, I have not played around with the day slider. Only due to the crash in IV, both my call and put premiums have been dropped. Wherein the call premium, which was trading at 23, the price right now is 18.48, whereas the put premium, which was trading at 13.9, the premium right now is 9.5. We can see 4.5 rupees loss on the call side and 4.35 rupees loss on the premium on the put side, only due to the crash in IV by 25%. So doesn't matter whether is it a call option or put option, if the IVs crash, our call option will also reduce, our put premium will also reduce. Further, now let's say if the IVs increase by 25% from here, what is going to be the impact of it on our option premiums? So you see 4.5 rupees we are gaining on the call side, and also on the put side we are gaining 4.39 rupees. So to, I would say, conclude in a simple layman's term, if the IVs crash of a particular instrument, doesn't matter call option or put option, the premium will go down. If the IV spike, doesn't matter call or put, both call and put premiums will go up only due to the implied volatility going up. Now, talking about movement of IV. So, because as you know, the IVs can also give us a good strategy to trade into options. You know, now let's say if we get an instrument wherein if the IVs are going to crash, and you know, if we place a short strangle over there, although it is a high risk strategy, but just assume that if we place a short strangle where we short both call and put at the same time of a pretty far off strikes, the crash in IV will lead to us in a profit, right? So now, before jumping directly how we can find out those instruments, first try to understand how the IVs move. So IVs have a mean reverting characteristics along with them. IVs, their range can shift, but they can't keep on trending. So what I mean by keep on trending? Now let's say ki 1 year down the line, TCS's price was 2300 level. Right now price is TCS 3200. But idea is that TCS's price is trending after a point. It is not be the case like, you know, TCS's price going up till 2500, then again coming back to 2200. Then again going up to 2600 level, then again coming back to 2200 level. Obviously there would be some dips, but it keeps on trending on the upwards or the downward side. It is not mean reverting. Mean reverting means what? If a particular instrument, let's say IV of a particular instrument, if it goes up a lot, it will take a cooler down approach. When, we don't know, but we have observed that IVs, they can't keep on trending. They will, if they are reaching at its highest point, they will take a cooler down approach. If IVs have spiked up a lot of a particular instrument, they will take a cooler down approach. And if IVs take a cooler down approach, it will help us out if we create a short triangle. wherein both our call and put premium is going to get decayed, right? Similarly, if IVs are going at the lowest point, it will mean revert, and if the IVs, if they bounce from the lowest point, it will help us when we create a long straddle or something, wherein both we are going to earn from call and put premiums both. So now, first, a very important question, where are we going to get the implied volatility for each and every FNO script? So now the important question is where we are going to get the implied volatility for all the FNO scripts. So we have a IV tool designed for it. So all we need to do is just go on volatility grid and we will get to see all of the FNO scripts along with the implied volatility of it. So now let's take an example of Havells, where in Havells, I'll get to see the price, the implied volatility of Havells, then historical volatility of last 20 days, like whatever the days inputs we are giving in HV period, according to that the historical volatility would be calculated. IVR and IVP would be also plotted, which is implied volatility percentile, and IVR is implied volatility rank. Now, as we discussed that implied volatility have those mean reverting characteristics when it will revert if it is reaching at its highest point, if it is spiked up a lot. Now, if we want to find out out of the entire FNO basket, which all are the FNO scripts where the IVs have spiked up a lot, manually if we do it, it is an impossible task without a ranking method. I'll tell you why. Now let's say if Reliance's IV is trading in some different range, TCS's IV isn't trading in some different range itself, Havells IV is trading in some different range itself, there would be different range for IVs of individual stocks. Looking at only implied volatility, we can't figure it out ki whether the stock's IVs are trading at the highest or the lowest point. It is an almost impossible task, right? Because now let's say 46 is the implied volatility of Havells. Now that might be an ideal range wherein the Havells IVs trade, right? But now let's say if Reliance's IV reaches up till 46, the Reliance's IV for that matter might be a possibility that it is trading at the highest point. So we can't figure it out. So that is the reason there are two ranking methods, which is implied volatility percentile and implied volatility rank. Now let's try to understand it very, very quickly. Now let's try to understand implied volatility percentile. Now what is implied volatility percentile? Now that figure tells us how many percentile of the times our IVs have been trading the current IV. So, whatever the current IV of a particular instrument is, implied volatility percentile tells us that how many times it has been trading below the current IV. Okay. So now, let's say if there is a particular instrument wherein the implied volatility percentile is trading, IV percentile is trading at let's say 99. Okay. IV percentile is trading at 99, which indicates us what? That it indicates us that 99 percentile of the times of last 250 days, whatever the current IV is, the previous IVs were trading below the current IVs. So which will tell us, you know, the stock's IVs have gone up at its peak. They are trading very high right now. Similarly, if implied volatility percentile is very low, which will indicate us what? That majority of the times that the stock's IVs have been trading below, above the current IV. Similarly, if the IV percentile is very low, which indicates what? That majority of the times, whatever the current IVs are, the previous IVs were trading above the current IVs. So, high implied volatility percentile indicates that the IVs are trading at its peak. So, you can use the sort by symbol out here. So, automatically the scripts where the IV is very high. So, implied volatility percentile, whichever script is highest, that would be shortlisted on the first. So Cadillac is the script where the implied volatility percentile is 96. So now it tells us that out of last 250 trading sessions, whatever the current IV is of Cadillac, 96 percentile of the times it were trading the below current IV. So now it tells us that the current IV of Havells Cadillac, they are trading at 91 and 96 percentile, which indicates that they have witnessed a sudden spike in IV wherein the percentile is very high. So we can simply use the implied volatility percentile methodology over here and identify the instruments wherein the IV is been trading very high. So I hope the implied volatility percentile logic is clear. So basically a ranking method which will easily help us to find out which stocks are trading at the highest IV points. Now discussing about implied volatility rank. Now implied volatility rank is another ranking method. Now let's say there are 2 points of a stock's IV. Let's say the lowest point is 20, the highest point is 60 of last 250 days. The lowest IV which was noted in a particular time frame in a particular stock, the lowest was 20, the highest was 60. So simple, whenever the IV comes at 20, okay, 20 or below that, our implied volatility rank will become 0. Whereas whenever the IV goes near the highest point, which is 60, so the implied volatility rank will become 100. Like 60 or above it, the implied volatility rank will become 100. That it is a ranking method will tell you where exactly you are placed in terms of the ranking of IV. So higher the implied volatility rank, higher the implied volatility of the stocks, lower the implied volatility rank, lower the implied volatility of a stock. So 20 becomes our lowest point, 60 becomes our highest point. Whenever it comes near 20 or below it, our IVR will become 0. Whenever the IV goes up till 60 and above that, our implied volatility rank will go above 100, which will indicate us that the ranks. So it will tell us that where we are placed in terms of the implied volatility rank of an selected instrument. So we can use the implied volatility rank sort by in implied volatility tool, wherein whichever stock trading at the highest implied volatility rank, we will get to see it. So Metropolis, as it has been a recent addition, so we will try to ignore it. So talking about Cadillac, it is trading at 76 implied volatility rank of last 250 trading session. So in terms of implied volatility rank, I would say there is no stock which is trading very close to its highest rank of last 250 days. So now talking about the lowest IV, so let's take an example of Dabur. So implied volatility rank of Dabur is 0. So which indicates that Dabur's current IV are trading at the lowest point of last 250 trading sessions. Like there was no data point as such where the IVs are been trading the below current IV. And you see the IVR is also 0 out here. So now using these ranking methods, which is implied volatility percentile and implied volatility rank, we can find out the FNO instruments where the IVs are trading at the highest or the lowest point. Now the important question is, which one should we use? Is it the implied volatility rank or implied volatility percentile? Choice is all ours, but try to use one ranking method at a time. Don't try to combine both of the ranking methods, elsewhere you might not get any of the result out there. So either implied volatility percentile or implied volatility rank, any one of it will give us a good result. So now what is the use of understanding this? Now let's say ki if we sort it down as per implied volatility percentile. So now what is the importance of understanding the implied volatility concept? Because now let's say we are trading into options. So despite predicting the price, if we find out the FNO instruments where the IVs are very high and if we are ready to take an unlimited risk scenario, we can probably create a short strangle in something like Havells, wherein the IVs are trading at their highest point, but the only thing is there would be an unlimited loss scenario. But also we can convert it into an iron condor, wherein we can try to short the calls and puts and buy far OTM calls and put. So wherein our strategy would be hedged, we won't be facing an unlimited loss scenario. So if Havells IV take a cooler down approach from here, and ultimately we are going to get the call and the put premiums both at the same time, despite Havells being at the same direction. So now I am in implied volatility chart tool, wherein you will get to see the historical data of implied volatility, wherein the orange line is indicating the implied volatility of that stock, whereas the green line is indicating us the futures price. Now if we see this, there are some dots mentioned out here on the graph. So these dots indicates that on that day the stock had announced its result. And if we focus on the graph of IV, it is not trending anywhere. If it is going at the highest point, it is kind of coming back to its normal approach. Similarly, if it is going at the lowest point, which is at 26.6, it is giving a spike from there. So right now it is at 46.33, the Havells IV, which has spiked up a lot. So I would say that pretty much was it from this video. Thank you so much for joining me up till here. If you have liked this video, do hit the like button, do hit the bell icon, so whenever we post something new, you will receive a notification. Apart from that, thank you all, and see you all in the next video.